When I was a kid, there were two book series I remember getting really deep into. One, of course, was the Harry Potter series. The other was the Magic Treehouse series. The Magic Treehouse is a series of children's books by Mary Pope Osborn that began running in 1992 and are still going today. The books are Adventure of the Week style, following these two children who travel to periods throughout time, or just around the world, with the powers of magic, usually to retrieve something needed for Morgan le Fay. At some point, I stopped reading the books, but I still have fond memories of reading them when I was younger.
More recently, it's been announced that Lionsgate has acquired the rights to the books to make it into a movie, with a tentative release date about 2019, maybe. But before that happens, let's take a look at this 2011 anime film, produced by Eiji Adu. Now, Eiji Adu is also a studio known for Zettai Shonen, as well as Emma, A Victorian Romance, the second act.
The movie specifically draws from books 1, 2, 4, and 13, but also uses a single plot arc featured in books 5 through 8. As I mentioned in the start, the story centers on two children, siblings Jack and Annie, as they go around to various points in time, exploring the worlds around them, and needing to recover a special artifact from that era. Among the places they go to includes Pompeii on the day of its destruction, which, yes, as I mentioned, happens in the book. There's also a running subplot around Jack having to be in a school play of Romeo and Juliet, but being a shy type, he's naturally off-put by the idea. Although originating from a Western book series, naturally this anime takes on the far more anime aesthetic to it visually. The character designs in particular are actually based more upon the Japanese versions of the books, which featured illustrations by the artist Okama, whose designs work have been featured in several anime, including Kosete no Shozo, as well as providing the costumes for the video game No More Heroes. The movie still looks really great though. The animation is pretty, the character designs are really cute and nice. There is CGI in the anime, but it's not abused, so it actually works very well for when it's needed. Though oddly enough, sometimes there's real stock photographs used as backgrounds. It doesn't happen too often, but I just don't like when real photographs or real video footage seeps its way into animation. It just looks really gaudy. Thank goodness it doesn't happen very often, like I mentioned. Although it has been some time since I've read the books, from what I do remember, the movie still feels very on par to the spirit of the original books, where Jack is still the reserved and studious type, while Annie is the adventurous risk-taker. I don't recall Jack being so shy, but as I mentioned, it has been a long time, and it's not as though I think it hurts the character anymore either. Given the books are adventures of the week, having a central subplot around our two young characters, I think, gives the movie needed moments of rest and gives a good story about gaining confidence and finding one's own ability. Cliché? Yeah, perhaps a bit, but this movie is for younger audiences, and they could go so much worse with it, so I can't fault them too hard for that. At least it's not the usual cliché, I just don't fit in plot. Unfortunately, this movie has never seen release outside of Japan, and that's a real shame because it is such a good movie, especially for kids and families. And now with the live-action movie in development, I'm kinda doubting this will ever see the light of day on US shores.
I do hope this movie will serve as a good base for Lionsgate to see how they can properly adapt these series of books into a good movie, or even a series of movies if it becomes to that. As such, I don't expect them to copy this movie precisely, but I hope that at the very end of the day, Lionsgate can show the same care and attention that the Japanese showed to these books. With that, I'm ShadowBlazer3000. Thanks for watching.
You know, for kids!